Students, today we will try to understand how to solve numerical problem related with Newton's second law of motion with the use of free body diagram. How to apply Newton's second law of motion especially. All of you remember that we were solving numerical problem based on Newton's second law of motion. So now question is, how to solve numerical problem related with Newton's second law of motion, maybe connected body problem, and also using free body diagram concept. So that is important because these are important steps we can learn when we are using free body diagram concepts. So what is this free body diagram? Today I will explain, and also I will explain how to solve the connected body problem. So these 2 points we will apply while we will solve the numerical problem based on Newton's second law of motion. So our problem solving skill will increase, will enhance. So that is very important part of any numerical problem solving. We should understand in detail how to get a step by step solution. Newton's second law of motion, basically very important concept, very important law. Actually, mostly numerical problem in mechanics without using Newton's second law of motion is very difficult to solve. So you remember Newton's second law of motion two ways. First, you remember rate of change of momentum is directly proportional to applied force. That means force is change in momentum by change in time. You remember this way. And secondly, you remember that F is equal to ma. Also, this is one of the important step that you remember. So let us try to solve the connected body problem in this way. Force and laws of motion. This is our actually chapter going on, and we are solving connected body problem. What is the meaning connected body problem? We will use free diagram concept. Free diagram of body. And also we will use Newton's second law of motion. So what is this all concept? We will see a problem. In this problem, maybe a pulley is taken pulley, you know, this is massless pulley. Pulley you might have seen in different type of temples, in different temples or anywhere where we can pull water with the help of pulley. This is massless pulley and two bodies, a lighter body of a small m and maybe a heavier body of capital M. These two are connected in this system. So what happens? What will be the technique how the body will be accelerated in this type of situation? How the body will be accelerated, that I will explain. maybe due to the weight, greater weight of this bigger body, where m is greater than m, body will accelerate in this condition. So this will come downward with some acceleration, and smaller body will move upward with some acceleration. Both of acceleration will be same, and that is the meaning connected body problem. So we will use here, if the system is allowed to fall or maybe allowed to move, then this will come down with an acceleration A, and small body will go up with some acceleration A. How to calculate this, the value acceleration, that I will explain, and also the tension that is developed in the string, that also I will calculate. So this we will see with the help of free body diagram. So what is the meaning of free body diagram? Free body diagram is actually a picture in which all the forces acting on any particular body is mentioned. Let us here talk about free body diagram of greater body M. So what will happen? Let's see. Free body diagram of heavier body. Having mass M. So we are showing by a point, maybe weight is acting downward and the tension is acting upward. Tension is in the string, because result is downward acceleration. So Newton's second law of motion, if we are applying, so what we see, that net external force is equal to zero. So downward force mg minus upward force tension is equal to net downward force mass into acceleration. So net external force, actually we know that net external force is mass into acceleration. That is our part. Net external force acting on any body is mass times acceleration. This is Newton's second law of motion in mathematical form. In mathematical form. So this we are using for heavier body. So this is our equation. Maybe the first equation. Now talk about less heavier body, which is going down. Here also weight is acting down, tension is up. So T must be greater than its weight, small mg, so that it will go up. So free body diagram of less heavier body. You know, this is actually free body diagram, where this point shows the body and the forces acting on the body, maybe the weight, tension, or maybe any other forces also. That picture is actually known as free body diagram, where all the forces acting on any particular body is shown. We are not talking the two body together, we are talking separate body. That is free body. The meaning free body. Now for a smaller body. Weight is a force is acting downward, and tension of the string, tension pulls. So here what we see, net is acceleration upward, so that means T is acting upward, upward force minus downward force is the net force, again using Newton's second law of motion, net force. This is the Newton's second law of motion we are using. this you can take it equation 2. Now we will use we will solve these two equations 1 and 2 to get the answer for maybe acceleration and then for tension. So generally in this type of problem, how much tension is acting, and that we have to calculate. How much acceleration is there, that also we have to calculate. This is actually connected body problem. Acceleration A of the system and to find tension in the string. So that is our main target. So what we are doing actually, we are actually solving this 1 and 2. And you see, when we are adding 1 and 2, when we are adding 1 and 2, minus 2 plus 2 cancel, and here m will be common. A common, we can take it addition. So finally, we are getting acceleration. You see what is the result? M minus M into G divided by small m plus M. This we have obtained for acceleration of the system. So this way, if you are putting the value of A in any of the equation, the value of the A we are putting, we can get the value T. So we can do this. So if you are putting A maybe in the equation 2. So putting A in equation 2, so what we will get, let's see. Minus mg we are bringing this side. We are putting A in place of A, we are putting the value. Take the LCM. So what will be the LCM? M plus M. And then this side will be simply multiplication. Multiplication of this. Here what we will do? Here we will do this multiplication. And then M into M. And M square. G. So finally, breaking the bracket, plus M square G minus M square G cancel. This will be addition 2 mm. This is the value of tension. Tension means, tension is also a force. And it works. How it works? Because it will pull. It is pulling actually. Tension pulls the lighter body up. You know, in this case, tension is more. And in this case, weight is more. So it comes down. So this type of problem, we have to solve more. And this is called actually the way free body diagram we are using and applying Newton's second law of motion to solve connected body problem. So we will solve more problems. Okay, students. Okay, for today, you must try and you must know how to solve this connected body problem. Okay, students, thank you. See you again. Okay.